And we have to analyze these 8 buildings in the period of this 16 weeks, what we have remaining, that is. And there are a set of things that we need to analyze them through. Okay, we will give you all that. We will type it here on the chat. Okay. So this is the idea. This is how we're going to begin today. I'm going to show you all, talk to you all about the importance of diagramming and making diagrams. Okay, and across, and just going to have some little fun examples for you all to see why, how diagramming is so important. You know, life changing. Like, how, wow, there are life within the effects. Okay, diagramming like that. So some things like that. Okay, and then we will what we are thinking is that then we all break into groups. Okay, right now we have 4 in each. Okay, I mean, we thought you all should also contribute and in each of these sets. Okay, but you have 4 to begin with. You all should have a discussion amongst yourselves. So I think what will happen by the end of what, after we have probably spoken to you all will get into your groups. What might happen, you all, that you all will probably begin to, you all might have to create a drive for your own groups. Okay, we can do it in the file itself here and create group 1, group 2 drives like that, like folders. And you can start collecting stuff up for each of these buildings. Okay, like in information, literature, essays, ideas about, or sometimes even video clips of these architects talking about their work. Okay, things like that. What we need to do is we need to reduce, like last time what we said, you need to reduce these architectural manifestations into pure diagrams to understand what are the various influences, okay, that might have that have influenced in the making or the thinking of the design for these architectural manifestations. Okay, so that's the primary thing. Okay, what will happen is that by the end of this week, okay, you all will give us, okay, maybe we continue working in the Teamscar folder system itself. You all will, or maybe on this, Excel sheet itself, you all will give us some keywords, okay, against each of those architectural buildings. Okay, the keywords basically would mean what you all, or maybe a gist sometimes, or maybe a sentence, however you all think. The thing that those keywords across all the 10 groups will help identify certain kind of themes under the larger architectural umbrella. Okay, so we think it's a common narrative that we will build in the class, and there is also a way to engage with the AP against the 2. Okay, and also help build this whole thing together. Okay. Because I feel in the last so many years in teaching, so sometimes when there is an equal kind of responsibility shared by the faculty and the students, there's much more learning. Similarly to what we have done in Allied Design last year, you guys did the Chindo group. Okay, you all know what has happened. I mean, so this is an idea. This is what we will do. Okay, Swati and I will begin to curate it, help you all. We will be part of your discussions. We will give direction to those discussions. Okay, and by the end, we will have a reader, okay, which will have 80 buildings, okay, which has been analyzed by your batch, okay, which you guys can refer for life. Okay, always I still refer to my notes that I have prepared or was taught in my when I was studying, and it's very helpful. So like what we said in the beginning in the first class, that this is what we are thinking. We want you all to build your own kind of methods for designing and design thinking, and because you are in the third year, okay, and as I said earlier, and like what Vimal also said, this is the first part of your architectural education, which ends in the third year by the council, and that means you should be able to, okay, build and design and execute a building which is almost around 1,000 square meters. Okay, that's the idea, basically. Okay, so yeah, so that is the larger spectrum of this whole course. Okay, every course, every lecture, okay, we will before, I mean, much well in advance, we will take out two groups to present what they have probably identified a certain kind of commonalities or differences between the buildings that they are studying. Okay, and likewise, we will also begin to thematize this. Okay, so maybe so between Swati and I, we have been thinking that there might be, say, probably we'll be able to thematize it. We might be able to come up with some themes depending upon what how you all reciprocate after you all have analyzed these buildings. Okay, and these things, everything is a group work. Okay, so please be sure that discussions are a must. Okay, you all need to grow together. Okay, and need to discuss. Okay, see things together. Okay, really helps as a community, as a peer leadership. Okay, and builds a character. Okay, so that is what the primary kind of underlining thing that we both believe in. Okay, so yeah, that is what it is. There is a bell going around my house, so have to wait the clocks close. Yeah, Swati, you want to add?
There's going to be a lot of background sound from my side on right now, but I think George, maybe it's good for them to start off, and we can then speak. I think everything that you said has covered most of it for them to get a direction. So
yeah. So I'll do one thing. I'll just make that presentation. This is normally I make this presentation for the fourth year students and the master students. It's about on diagramming. Okay, I'll make that presentation. Yeah, you guys are all awake and there, no? Alive.
Yeah.
Okay. Present. And if we are boring, just say, "Bahut bore kar raha hai, band karte hain," and it's okay. Okay, let's be frank about it. Okay. There's some light here from the other side of the world. Okay. Okay, can you see my screen?
Yes, we can see it.
So I mean, this is called urban diagramming, but largely pressing on the fact that why diagramming is an important act of thinking, and diagramming is not it's not confined within the boundaries of a drawing. Okay, it can also be models making. It can be model making. So any act of thinking. Okay, I'm saying any act of thinking. Has to have a very tangible form of making or drawing, or you know, I don't know why this has gone off again. Okay, so and also diagramming is such a thing that it is reactionary. You are reacting to something that's happening around you. Okay, you're reacting to a brief that has been given to you. Okay, Hausmann reacted to the idea of wanting to getting the army immediately into the square. So he just cut the whole street and created boulevards and avenues. Okay, or you're reacting. Bibi Doshi reacted to the whole idea of creating Aranya housing through a very simple diagram, which I think is part of this, where he draws that how farming, housing, corporate life, everything can coexist. And there's a nice drawing that he has made. And that drawing became the source of inspiration for the whole Aranya housing plan. So I'm saying these diagrams are such that they react to a state of mind, to a state of condition, to a situation. They're also a repository of data, of information. It allows one to be able to sometimes use the diagram to pick out things. Okay, to pick out things. This is what you guys will probably be doing. Okay. And also diagrams are very they have an insight. They create these visions of the future for the future, be it Corbusier's idea of the city building, or even you know the broad acre city by all these guys, FLW and So I think there is a large understanding of what or I think it's there's a misuse or misunderstood scope of what diagramming can do. Diagram forms the basic structure, okay, or for any kind of architectural manifestation that one creates. Okay, we all begin with diagrams, but we are not conscious about it. But what we're trying to say is that you need to begin to become conscious about the act of making the diagram. Okay, so yeah, so begins with John Berger's ideas of ways of seeing. Okay, where he very clearly here itself is I've taken a quote from his book. We never look at just one thing. We are always looking at the relation between things and ourselves. And I think that's a brilliant thing because it is about these relationships. And architecture is the host. It's the space where you are trying to stitch relationships. Okay, and these relationships matter. These relationships can be broken. These relationships can be mended. And architecture can play a role. An effective role in creating these creating these scenarios. So in his thing is that so it's all ultimately depends on the way you see. Okay, the way you see. So he always says seeing comes before the words. The child looks and recognizes before it speaks, and it's true. René Magritte's idea of not calling the egg an egg, not calling the hat a hat. But you know, calling it different names, but then you begin to associate the image and the text, and then one realizes, okay, he's calling the egg a moon. Okay, so maybe there's a resemblance of people are thinking. You begin to interpret. I think the scope and the space for interpretation is such an important thing. Any public space, when it intends to become a public place, is when people have the right, the freedom, the accessibility to access that space in their own right and mind. Okay, I've always believed that public spaces is something that we can design. Okay, but to make a space a place, okay, will only happen when you allow people to interpret it. Okay, so there are very few public places, but there are many public spaces, and not all public spaces are places. Okay, so though it's a kind of a word trivia kind of a thing, but the underlining meaning is that from René Magritte's idea of let there be space for interpretation, because and that is what that allows a certain space for of a you are setting up a relationship between right now in this case between him, the painter, and the reader. Okay, so what so he says it's a union that suggests the essential mystery of the world. Art for me is not an end in itself, but a means of evoking that mystery. Magritte would often display ordinary objects in an unusual context. This would give new meanings to familiar things and objects as other than what they seem is typified normally as. So that's amazing. That's when you create new meanings. Because using John Berger's idea of ways of seeing, that means you create a lens to see. Okay, and when you create a lens, you are actually at the threshold of creating a new meaning. Okay, and which leads to this drawing from Chakrata. I mean, I don't know, you guys might have seen this also. I thought it's such an important thing that we look at the larger image of Chakrata and take the Google Earth image and like, wow, what a village. Okay. But the village is born out of certain kinds of patterns of living. Okay. Like how the way it has been showcased here. Okay. That it is, we can very clearly see that there is an idea of how the everyday life, okay, is how the house becomes a space for interpretation, a space for an opportunity to create relationships between, in this case, between the honey and the honeybees, okay, and how the trap door is used to take honey out, and once honey is taken, and you know, so how these houses are actually stories of relationships, okay, or meanings that are embedded within it. So the final outcome of the pattern of the village the form of the village is born out of a unit understanding of relationships that people are engaging with nature, with people as social relationships, okay, with relationships with through work, okay, relationships through movement, are all these all constitute the building of this village. Okay, so the village is not born out of just let's leave some space here, let's leave that. I mean, that is one thing, but there are several set of relationships that come into play to be able to understand that the form is born out of those relationships. So then as architects, what do we do? And then you look at a motherboard. This is a very old motherboard diagram. And these are a set of relationships, a circuit diagram, which allows your laptop to work. And then after that, you have, say, an iPhone 6S, which is more complicated and complex, but the idea is the same as this. But here you go. Everything is packed into one small kind of instrument that you can hold in hand. And there you are there. I mean, we have right now, we are able to access videos, play music, and talk to people, and you know. So I'm saying that this set of information or the circuit diagram, there is a circuit diagram in Chakravarta too. Okay, there is a circuit diagram here. There's a circuit diagram in the iPhone itself. And these circuit diagrams are certain kinds of relationships that one begins to engage with. And set up new meanings. You know, set up new meanings in the quest of finding new forms of being itself. And this diagram, I love this one and these two diagrams. Why did the Germans lose the Battle of Waterloo? I think the Allied forces did a very good diagramming of how to overcome the Germans. Okay, and it's amazing if you look at the diagram here. The diagram saved the day for all of us and somewhere sees the war. Okay, and this is what it looks like. Okay, they push them through a narrow point and then they conquer them from all the other sides and they cut off their supply lines and their communication lines, and that's it. Once you cut off the communication line and this and the supply lines to your army, to your naval force, to then that's it. You have lost the war, actually, because you have no more supply lines coming in, and that's what they did. Okay, this is another diagram from the battlefield. Then they do it, and this somebody has analyzed this over it, and so I feel it's interesting that how these diagrams can also win wars. Okay, so this one. Okay, the diagram of the Battle of Plassey, where they you can very clearly see that they began to camp in such a way that they are able to attack because they had their darts and their arrows and their thing, and they knew that at this distance we will be able to overcome the wall that they built. Okay, and so then again a diagram really works, and you have a map, you have a way to survey the land and then position your army in such a way to able to conquer that. Okay. The plan, this is the in 1957-58, the first war of independence. Okay, the plan for that, which was something drawn by the British Army, how to conquer it. Okay, so I'm just showing you all some kind of these diagrams, I would say. Okay, now diagrams on a map. Okay, how it really probably one can see how certain forms of diagramming allow certain access. Okay, or this is one of my colleague, an alumni from CareWare, where what she's done an overlaying of three drawings. Where she's looking at the tracing of these three kinds of shifts that have happened. The colorful drawings is her intervention, okay, her response, and the other two are drawings of the current condition of the Mandateshwar caves and the earlier before the caves, what was it, and then and she what she's done she spliced all of it together to understand what is the architectural proposition that can be born out of this splicing or bringing together or montaging these different drawings together to be able to see what can be the architectural manifestation. Okay, this is again another form. This is Abhaya Kacham. This is a thesis work. What you can see from the left to the right are these three verticals. Okay, the left vertical, what you can see are experiences, okay, of color, of smell, of touch. Okay, the second vertical, that is this the middle one, the middle vertical is where these things are, where those colors and textures and those touch or those things that have been felt, okay, as experience, where are they found on objects. And the third vertical is where it is found in the whole site. Okay, so this diagram establishes an idea for probably sets up the idea of what the architecture could be. Okay, very clearly looking through the sense of the stimuli to the tangible idea and to a very kind of withdrawn idea of the site and the region. Okay, or this is my thesis diagram where I was looking at how to somehow inject into the everyday banal life of ours some form of celebration, and I looked at the idea of the festival and use that as a scope to inject it into this space of the everyday, okay, where then the involuntary participation becomes excess celebration and ordinary life becomes becomes a thing that we will look forward to for the next day and the coming days, and thus making these banal everyday life into something that is celebratory. So I mean, this is again an idea. I'm just going to run through why I'm trying to establish why this diagramming is something that you'll be will begin to or have to begin to consciously do it. Okay, you are doing it, but you're not conscious maybe about it. Some of y'all may be. Okay, I'm not denying that. This is my friend Owen, his thesis, and he's created the food mandala. And the food mandala in Bombay especially, and then looked at the various communities and the kind of food ecosystem that revolves around this whole community, and then the architectural urban diagram was born out of this food mandala. Or this is a studio that was conducted by I think this was conducted by Hussein, Sheta, Shirish with called Ecologies of Food. There was an Ecologies of Waste also, and this was being conducted with a school from Switzerland, and they were looking at how these food networks, okay, really matter and how they actually form a certain kind of an idea of accessibility, of movement, of production, of post-production. Okay, so this was just to set that out, and the various kinds of stakeholders who take part in this, from private companies to government to cooperative societies to farmers, and how and also the final outcome of when it ends in a market or the end user kind of understanding. So the network diagram, almost similar to the network diagram of the laptop, laptop's motherboard, this looks very similar to that. So, or here it is Archigram, okay, Peter Cook. Okay, we wanted to make a space where one can find, like he created these capsules, and how these capsules can be added or modified as and when the city grows, and then so thus calling it the plug-in city. And each of these things that you can see on the screen right now are all these kind of set of plugins for dwelling units, as dwelling units being plugged in into the whole kind of structure of the city. You can remove it. So there is already a crane that is being hoisted out here, okay, that keeps changing these plugins as and when people require it. Or John Hedrick's idea of the sketch for the victims. This was actually a I mean, it was not built actually. I think only he built one part of it. So he was commissioned this project to look at the site where certain kind of episode of set of Israelites and Jews were killed, and then wanted to commemorate that whole act and, you know, and remember that brutal act. And he was commissioned this job, and he created these various kinds of building types, okay, or archetypes, and named them. And you can see them. There is a horticulturist, there's a judge, there's a peacock, there's a catfish, there's a typesetter, and each of them denotes a certain kind of form. The text allows a certain kind of form. Okay, now this is also, this is somewhere you can connect between Magritte and John Hedduk's idea of the text and the form. And this is that site, actually. And what I've done, I've done that. Okay, so this is the site, and this is his sketch, actually. And this is the present scenario of the site. So these buildings are not built. One was built and one was actually, I think, removed. And otherwise, this is what it is like, you know. Just imagine all those set of objects. This, I think, 46 or something, 67 objects would have been arranged on this site as an idea to sing. But right now, what you see are, there is a museum, there's an exhibition hall. They continue to use the site as a public site for activities, but not the John Hedduk idea. Or this is something that I'll not probably sing, but always there's also the city plan, and this is about Jodhpur and how there are these set of diagrams that are there, and these diagrams hold the city structure together, okay, allowing it to grow, allowing it to expand, sometimes also disallowing certain kinds of expansion and things. And these diagrams are also born out of in respect to the contours of the site. So there are. So I always say this, that when we get a green field work or a project or both in the academic space or outside, there are some diagrams that the site offers. Sometimes they are contour lines. Sometimes they have wind directions. Sometimes they are sunpath diagram. But there are some, or sometimes there are also movements of people, okay, who move across the land. Okay, sometimes it's some movement of animals. So the diagramming is something to reduce what we see, okay, into a pure form, where we then are able to identify the various kinds of aspects that are present or prevalent in that context. Okay. So similarly, now when we'll look at these architectural diagrams, that is what will happen. And I will end with Korea's this diagram of Navi Mumbai. This was commissioned somewhere in 85, and this is what it happened. We wanted to move to a new city because Bombay didn't have much of a place, and redevelopment was not on the cards yet until now. That's happening around us right now. And they built a new city. Definitely, there are different aspects that why people didn't move and stuff. But what is interesting is that it was born out of a relationship, a diagram between the old city and the new city. Okay. Which gave birth to a certain kind of a pattern. This is his master. This is his kind of a vision plan that he had along with Praveena Mehta and Shirish Patel, and the three of them build this idea. And what helped is that there was a certain kind of aspect that they said that they will want to continue to respect, especially the water systems that were prevalent in this new city that now called Navi Mumbai. Okay, and they wanted to connect all of it and also say that we need to learn something from our past, and something that because Bombay underwent, you all know the history of Bombay. Bombay underwent a large scale reclamation. Okay, Ranjit, I don't know if you all know Ranjit. Ranjit is a very good friend of the school. Ranjit keeps saying that if at all, we wouldn't have reclaimed the lands, we could have been the Venice of this side of the globe, you know. There was this particular aspect that there are existing kind of systems that we have, and the plan for Navi Mumbai is born out of a way to complement the existing systems. Okay, and to be able to bring in a certain set of development that allowed a certain kind of growth. So we can very clearly see a very simple diagram. Okay, you have the railway line right in the center. that it runs through. I'll just use my cursor or something. Is a pointer. So a very simple thing with the railway line, and on both the sides of the railway line, you have the playing fields. Okay, and then you have the loop road that comes in close to the these point number C's and then goes away. Okay, such that it allows a certain kind of a rhythm. And also then C becomes the city center or nodal centers, okay, where you have the railway station, market and stuff, where everything meets together at one point and again diverges from there to again meet at some other point. So this is a basic diagram, but that led to the creation of the city. And yeah, I mean, this is that part. This is this is Palm Beach Road. Okay, this is that part of the thing. I think this is one of the photographs. One of the alumni. He was able to take an aerial shot. So yeah. So this is that picture. So anyways, I'm ending here. We can then probably discuss and move to our groups. You have any questions, we can answer that. Okay, so largely it is going to be this. What Swati and I presume what will happen is this, that you all will go through these buildings in your own kind of space, okay, and probably come back and discuss, okay, because I think you all will also need time to go through these buildings, okay, and to be able to come back and discuss, okay. So this is going to be a group thing, assignment, okay. College project is part of college project. College project has two subjects, one is history and one is tectonics, okay. History has 50 grades, 50 marks, and so will tectonics will have 50 grades, okay. We will, I mean, to be honest, all of you will pass, okay. So just chill on the grade part, okay. So just chill on that. But what we want to do is, this is something I always feel, I don't know, Swati, what you think, but I feel that I had a lost opportunity where I didn't think that 5 years of architectural education was the time and space where I could have developed my own kind of styles or ideas of building architecture, or like my own toolkit, okay, my own toolkit, set of toolkits in terms of operations, in terms of software building, in terms of thinking, in terms of my alliance to a certain set of idea, you know. So I feel it was very important to think that this 5 years of education allows one to do that, okay. And I think we need to consciously develop our own kind of agencies, okay, our own kinds of methods, okay, of design thinking, okay. So that really would help, and I think we think that the Tectonic Studio can become the space, can become that easy space, which allows a certain kind of conversation, sharing, okay, with your peers, with us, okay, and it might really help. So yeah, Swati, you want to add?
Yes, I actually wanted to pick one point from the presentation also, George, and just highlight that. I think it was evident graphically, but I'm not sure it has come out to these guys immediately. I feel like the first step could also be today, when you all are looking at these projects and starting a discussion. I think it would be nice for the building a vocabulary, basically building a vocabulary as a tool for diagramming. So basically, if, like George had said, a set of keywords to put together. I think that is what we are meaning when we say, you know, building a set of vocabulary, which we will be able to pick from and then work further and, you know, develop a lot more of understanding. From, of course, and additionally, all that George showed had a very strong graphic identity. I think that is something that y'all would be able to decipher for each of these projects from your intuitive understanding of it, and also the readings that you would probably do in terms of the research. But for the discussion that you want to have within your group, sorry, there's just too much.
Yeah, it's okay, it's all right.
The discussion that you want to have within your group, I think it would be important to be very vocal about some of these words which stand out, you know, for these projects. I think that is one way to go today, immediately.
Yeah.
And George, we'd also like them to then record their meetings, right? So that
he yes. So that we can also hear it if we have missed some thing, and also they can also revisit. My idea is that to revisit is an important thing. We don't have the habit of that. Yes. Sometimes I don't know how many of y'all do it. I used to have a very bad habit of doing sketches on loose sheets of paper and then don't get them. So then I started recording what I'm thinking. I'm making a drawing and I'm also speaking. So sometimes I revisit those kind of recordings, some gibberish sometimes, but it really works. So we are talking about developing methods, guys. Developing methods, okay. At home, people will call you mad. Okay, my dad thinks that this architecture thing is really crazy. Nothing to study, no books, and what he's talking and what he's drawing, I don't remember. So it still continues now also. The act, you all have to develop your own. I mean, you all have your own style. So first of all, there's nothing to copy from anybody else. Nothing. Don't copy, because if you copy, then you will not be you. Okay, so that is another problem, and then you will not be able to deliver actually what you would have actually done much better if you were behaving by yourself. You know, so I think that's an important aspect. So yeah, so I think without wasting time, we can probably go into these groups we've made. Okay, and have a chat there, have a discussion. I know. There will be teething issues. Okay, let us know. Put it on the chat. Okay, how to organize? You all decide that. Okay, if you all need help, you all let us know. But before we move, you all have to ask something, say something, comment. Let us hear from you all first.
George, just one point I want to add that we want them to start recording, like. Physically writing these points down also.
Like minuting.
Yeah, just minute your discussion. Individually. So all of y'all individually can minute discussion. So there's a lot more to look at. So it's not just one perspective.
Yeah.
There's all the perspectives. But yeah, I think they have some questions. Shravan, you want to go ahead?
Right. So I understand that we have to discuss and draw these diagrams, and obviously we diagram the buildings and also kind of connect the similarities as like looking at them as a group of structures and not just individually. But so when we actually present this, you say, I was confused about how we're supposed to present this. Like, will it be a kind of updating constantly thing, or like a finished product kind of a thing?
No. Nothing. There's nothing finished product, Shravan. So this is a constantly developing idea.
Yeah. Okay.
But what we are looking at, say by the end of this week, okay, if you all can give us your discussions, key kind of context or keywords, okay, maybe 1 to 10, okay, you all will give us that. So each group will come out with these keywords. So what Swati and I will begin to do is we both of us largely have an idea of thematics in our head, okay, but we thought it is unfair to force you all to think through those thematics, but rather develop those thematics along with you all. Okay, so each of these things, each of these discussions will generate a certain kind of this vocabulary, okay, your own individual vocabulary, okay, and within that there are embedded certain kinds of themes. So sometimes group one has a project, okay, and their thematic goes hand in hand with group 10's third project, okay. So what will happen there, we will begin to collect these kind of discussions that we are having and begin to arrange them in these thematics. So the reader, so we are calling this the reader, the reader that will get developed through these weeks, okay, will have several thematics, and each of the thematic will have these buildings that you all are analyzing, where it is not only text but also diagrams. You all will make diagrams of those buildings, because you all are trying to get in the head of the architect, the way that architect probably would have what are the various kind of influences that this influences that have influenced the architect to develop that kind of a building. Okay, so this is a piecemeal project. It is not like there is no idea of the finish in that thing. There is no idea of finish in terms of the look of the or the presentation style. Okay, it's very free in that sense. Like Swati has also prepared one template, but we thought we will not give you all that. Okay, but rather wait what is being produced and then decide the template. Otherwise, it always becomes that a template is enforcing you all to perform in such a way. Okay, so we wanted to restrict that. Don't want to restrict you all. I mean, bring in so many constraints. Okay, we want to keep it really free. So that is the one idea that we have. Shravan, is that fine?
Yeah. And you mentioned something
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know particularly. It might have answered your question. Okay. Huh. But I think, like I'm saying, this is something that we think should work. Okay. It will have its teething issues. Okay. Mm-hmm. But let's see. Now, I mean, how it goes. Mm-hmm. So, what is this? Do we have to work on all of our projects of the group simultaneously, or is the whole group working on each project? Good question. You are answer that. See, I between me and Swati, we were discussing that also. Okay. अरे क्या अभी eight projects दिया? तू एक काम करना, तू एक-एक ले ले हम लोग, एक-एक ले ले. That is also possible. Okay. But whatever it is ना, Namya, whatever it is, we will ask your group. We will ask your group. Hello, group number one. Okay, all of you all. Okay. What is your take on these projects? You might have divided that work, administrate. You might have done those coordinations. That's fine. You can do that. No problem.
So whether we discuss them simultaneously or we discuss at once and collate, that's up to us, essentially. Right?
Yeah.
That's what I'm understanding.
Yeah. Yes.
We are just hoping that all of you individually get to reflect on each of these projects in one way or another. Either, you know, it's through discussions and one person has kind of studied it further a little bit more and then come back and discussed it. Or is that all of you all have individually done it and then come back and kind of... So the process is up to you all to figure. It's open and it's fluid. But we'd like for all of you to at least bring... have learned something from it, and then we can all discuss it, right? That's what we're looking at, George.
Yeah. And every time when we meet, we will either have just by us, or sometimes we will have presentations by you all based on the discussions that you all have had in your group. So it's nothing that you have to create something. You don't have to create something for the presentation. Please, we don't want you all to begin to work on this in such a way that you have to discuss and then go and make a presentation. No, I would say that let's not get into those things. Okay, we can have an open discussion. We can have sketches. We can just maybe in the presentation, like a Google slide, everybody put their stuff in it and doesn't have to have a format. But what needs to get discussed is the analysis part. Okay, and the quality of that discussion. Okay, that's what we want to establish. Anybody else? Namya, did I answer that or confused?
No, we have a tendency. But, I actually had one more doubt in the sense that so basically, like for every class, do we have to like have the analysis of one of the buildings that we have for the whole group? Or are we doing all the buildings together?
That's okay. Kind of okay. Whatever. Okay. Listen. Your semester ends in September, October, somewhere there. September end, I think.
October.
Exam. Sorry. So September. Okay. So Namya and everybody else in the class. Okay. You all have to do 8 buildings for this whole semester. Okay. Just 8 buildings. Okay. How you all do it? Kind of a, oh God, my phone, did you all hear me that? Namya, so the thing is eight buildings, okay, for the whole semester. Eight buildings for the whole semester. How you want to organize, you can organize that. Okay. But what will happen? This first kind of session, okay, this by Saturday, you'll send us some stuff for me and Swati for us to begin to arrange and collate your discussions into thematics. Okay, these thematics we will write and we will discuss again with you all. Okay, there might be a thing where we will go on to the Miro board, okay, and put that thematics out there. And if you all think, no, George and Swati, this thematic doesn't work, we think we should be replacing it with this, it makes more sense. Or maybe you all will say, okay, there are some more thematics that are getting developed. The Miro board can have the set of thematics that can get developed also. We can go on to the Miro board also. You all please feel free to use anything that you all think is best to communicate and arrange this kind of discussion that you all are going to have. If Miro board works, please make a Miro board and give us access so we can see what's happening there. That also is, Miro board I think also works very well. So y'all can take a call. I would say I like the idea of the Miro board. So maybe y'all can make a Miro board thing as a class, and or maybe each group can make one Miro board and then give Swati and me access, and then we can see the work there. That is also fine. What's a thematic? Okay, so there are several themes that architectural manifestations and architectural projects can be put under. Okay, so for example, those thematics are like, for example, in my head right now there are a few of the thematics like collage city. Okay, there are the collage being an idea of assembling things. Okay, of bringing things together. So you can take any case, be it an heritage structure to a new building that has been posed in it, okay, or say the case of Rome, okay, where I was just talking to Swati also about it, about Venezia Roma, the terminal, where you have the new terminal building on top, but the old part of Rome still sits underneath that new building, where it hosts a series of other kind of activities. And the layer that is the further down is the one that has the subway. So if you take a escalator from the Roma Termini, okay, and if you start moving down to get into a subway, you can see all the old structures. So sometimes it's about history, the collage. So sometimes it's about collage can also be the idea of splicing multiple programs together, okay, something that Pompidou does sometimes, okay. Sometimes even some of the buildings where you have these NGO buildings, largely in Bhopal, or even Bharat Bhavan, okay, the way it splices in section different kinds of activities that are happening on the terrace. There is an exhibition at the bottom. There is an access to the lake, to the Bada Talab. Okay, and so I think collage is I'm just like giving you an example. Okay, collage. Okay, so collage can be a thematic. Okay, so like that we will find many thematics, okay, that is actually going to come out of your discussions, okay, where you all will find that, okay, there is a situation here where you have the building and the lake, or the building and the river, okay, there's a relationship, okay, and that relationship can throw up a theme, or can throw up a kind of a idea of that relationship can be written down. Okay, then together we both will begin to curate it, okay, then put it back to you all, and you all will then begin to say, we will have a larger discussion, and then we will finalize some of these themes, and within those themes we will begin to start arranging these buildings with your kind of diagrams on it. Yeah, Sahil.
So basically, by what you just said, I probably imagine something that we did in AD semester 3 was the reverse of this. So basically what we did was that we had gotten two keywords, a noun and a verb, and then we went on to our design. So this is probably, we have the designs and we are just finding the keywords. Is that correct, what we are supposed to do, right?
Correct. Because we started doing that keyword for you all, but we felt that that you are not in the second year, okay, and we felt that it is time for y'all to be able to give the keywords, okay, and y'all, because come on, this is another thing that we keep saying at KRVI. We respect y'all as adults, okay. You're free thinkers, and we want to continue free thinking and critical thinking. That is something that we can give you as teachers, as something that you all continue to do it. So I think that is very important aspect of education and learning, and that is something that, because all the time listening to us is sometimes quite boring, and sometimes quite dead end. I think okay, there is as much as teachers we can contribute also, no. So I feel sometimes I don't know, you guys are the best to tell. Sometimes I might be repeating many things that I have told you all in the second year also. Okay, but that is who I am. That's what I was trying to say. That is who I am. No? That is who Swati is. And so, but what is important is to understand, okay, at the third year level, there is a set of complexity that needs to be understood. And that complexity can only be understood if there is a collective learning framework. And collective learning ka framework hai, this is what we've developed, is we thinking that we don't know, we are trying this, that this is the framework for collective learning. Okay. Yeah. Tanvi?
Yeah, so in SEM 3, we actually had done this exercise in AD. So we had made diagrams for different buildings. So this is similar to that, right? We have to study the building on different aspects and then make the diagrams of it, our own diagrams.
So these diagrams are not going to be only of the buildings. Okay, we will now give you a list. I think you should give them the list of those influences, Swati. The list of influences, we can type it here.
Yeah.
So Tanvi, yeah, I agree. There is that the diagramming is going to be of two types. Okay, the diagramming definitely of the building, but not just of the building, but also building and the site. Okay, and its context. Okay, it's very important to begin to see the building contributing to its context also. The other aspect that I will put down here, there are certain kind of influences. Okay, influences that we have been talking about. Okay, that really matters for every architect while designing. Okay, so I'm putting it on the chat here. Okay, you all can probably copy it and save it or write it or something. So influences. So one is program. One is technology. And principles.
George, you're not quite audible on my end. I don't know if it's an issue for someone else as well, but there's a lot of disturbance in the background.
Okay, I think it's me. Just a second.
Okay, I've just chatted it. I've just put on the chat. Okay, influences, man. Okay, program, context is site and context. Okay, technology, aesthetics, time, ethics and principles. Okay, there might be few more that will now be emergent from your discussions, maybe. Or sometimes there might be sub categories to think, because I'm already thinking aesthetics, may there is an idea of semiotics and semiology maybe. Okay, so there is that possibility. Okay, so I don't know, so maybe those are something that will probably begin to churn out from your discussions. So this is like, so what will happen, Tanvi, that these influences are something you all will cross check for. Sometimes not all projects might have been influenced by all of these set of influences. Okay, sometimes it's just sometimes some of the influences might be major influences and the others might be very minor ones. Okay, so I feel that is the possibility. And maybe there are some influences that this is now a discussion between me and Swati. We've developed these influences, but you guys might come up with many more and you can add to it. Okay, does that answer your question, Tanvi?
Yeah, it does. Also, if you want us to record our own meeting, so you might need to make at least one of us from each group as owner, because we don't get the option to record.
Yeah. I'll do that. I realize that. So you all can't record any of these meetings. Only we can do it. But earlier, how you all could?
We never could record it. Either you need to be a member, owner, then only you can record it.
Okay. That we can.
Yeah.
Swati, what I'll
Or we'll have to resort to another platform, but then Teams is centralized for the entire college, so then that's better. Otherwise,
yeah, so it's not. If you're looking,
because Zoom ka 40 minute year, and I don't know if Google Meet records or not. Zoom ka 40 minute year. Teams is central to the college, so this helps.
Okay, we'll make one of y'all a owner, and then y'all this thing. Okay, or y'all can just tell us who all. Will take that responsibility. Somebody who will take that responsibility from each group, just text me or Swati and then we'll make your own. That's also possible.
We can list as a class and send it to you by today.
Har ek group mein give me one person.
And then, sheet actually just on the sheet, just mark whoever's going to become the.
On the sheet. On that Excel.
In red or something. Same color for all the.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Okay. Anything else?
Have you put up the list on the chat? Because I was not able. I'm not able to see. Is it on the chat? The list of influences.
Should I put it on the thing also? Excel. Thing. Just copy paste it there.
Then we can keep adding it there because they can also keep adding it there.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering, there were two others that I don't know if I should if we should give that out or should they come up with it.
What is that?
History, ecology.
Yeah, we can add that. Yeah, we can add it. Why not?
That's
what I'm saying. I put it on that thing, on that chat of now. On that Excel sheet. On top left corner. You can add it there.
I'm just taking a.
So what will happen is this. I don't know how to show you all this. Maybe. What will happen is that your discussions will have the architectural manifestations, these buildings, architectural manifestations. And you will run it through, you will make those diagrams, you will run it through the influences, okay, and to finally arrive at some summaries, okay, and some kind of keywords and vocabulary that you will develop. Once you'll send that to us, then we will begin to curate the themes for you all, okay. Then we can have an open discussion about the themes, okay, and then we can begin to, then we will prepare, probably an InDesign file. And maybe we will ask some volunteers to help for the preparing the InDesign file for the reader, and that's it. And then every discussion after you all finish your thing, you all have had a good discussion, and you'll have a diagram and some things coming out of it. They can all be put into the InDesign thing directly. So as we move ahead, we can keep building up InDesign file for each of the group. Okay, that's the like an idea to compile so that we don't rush on the last day to compile everything and all that stuff. So trying to avoid that. So plan out in such a way that as we move ahead, this thing gets compiled as we move ahead. All right. Anything else, guys? I mean, y'all will have more questions and maybe some kind of troubleshooting will have to be done at some point. all that, I think that will definitely happen. Okay. So I think we have some 15-20 minutes. So what we can do is right now, probably you all can just move into your groups and discuss. Okay. And and then say on Saturday, let us say that you guys, we expect that you have something, a keyword or something. What we can do is also use the same Excel sheet at the bottom, have like a row for keywords. What do you think, Swati, that at the bottom of the listing, let them type it there itself for now?
Yes, that would be convenient. So we can
We have one file for everything right now. And then slowly when we think that, okay, now there are diagrams and images that are coming up, so we want to, then we can probably move to Miro board. Miro board also is a good space to archive things in a way. So that also might be interesting. So that, guys. No response. Hello.
Yes, you are.
Baki sab kya kar rahe? Riya. Riya Vaidya.
Sorry, George, you mentioned that you want this on Saturday. Like, are you talking about this Saturday? Like, do we have a class? I don't know.
No, we don't have a class. We are talking this Saturday. You all have a discussion, no? Chai, coffee, pay.
Okay,
fine. Namya, you are saying something? So you were saying.
I was only saying.
Okay, you're only saying. Ambika, you've not been talking. You've only been chatting.
A lot of background noise. Did you say Ambika?
Yeah, I said Ambika. Any questions, any queries, any suggestions?
At the moment, no. I think it'll be important for all of us to, I think the group to meet once on Saturday. I've created a group. We're all discussing things right now. So I think what's going to help is creating that InDesign file and figuring out how we're going to diagram things. That's going to be interesting. So yeah, I'll speak to the group and get back to you.
Ask you one thing. When you watch a movie, when a new movie is out in the block, okay, probably you guys all go and watch it, then you all have a discussion about the movie, the character, and the cinematography.
Yeah,
who was that? I don't know what's happening. Did someone say something? You're all tired. Thanks. Afternoon lecture.
George, I was thinking, since group coordination is the biggest issue and we don't want to have a rush discussion for the sake of Saturday, even if we could move it to, Monday or Sunday, we could actually, get together and discuss on the weekend when everyone is free. So some people right now nocturnal or, something like that.
No, I would say then, okay, can we do this? We can send us something by Monday, because then Swati and I then get at least a day and a half to work on doing the things. Otherwise, it becomes too hurried for us. So you all can have a discussion in the week on a Saturday, no problem. I'm just saying these discussions by itself, don't have to create rough work and fair work. The discussion itself is a fair work. Okay, and that discussion, whatever the discussion entails with or ends with, okay, there will be some kind of conclusions that you all will make. Okay, those are enough for us. Okay, so maybe I agree with what you're saying. Maybe you all can do a kind of a study of these buildings from today onwards. Today is Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Saturday evening. Have an hour long discussion. That's enough. Don't.
Yes.
Time manage that discussion. Don't let it go anything more than 45 minutes. It's banal. Nothing comes out of it. I have very correct kind of thing. You all can even prepare if you all want an agenda. Some people say, I will talk about this building and I will talk about these things. That's it. Right now, there are four buildings for each of you all. You all can pair up, okay, and do the thing. Okay. The remaining four or three that we want to add, we can do it later, not now. But I would say, beginning, you all can even break it into pairs and you all can have pair based discussion. But what ultimately is that you have to help each other also. Okay. You have to help each other also. Okay, so that means I'm weak at analyzing something, but and Swati is better. Okay, so Swati being in the group will help me analyze things. So this is what I'm calling about peer education is important. Okay, so once you'll give us something, then we will be able to schematize, put those themes. Okay, and then discuss next class in the beginning, and again we can break into groups. Okay, so Monday is fine.
So just to confirm, George, just to confirm, so we all are on the same page as the class. We have a meeting, and by Monday we put some result of our discussion, whether keywords or whatever, on the Excel sheet, and then that's what the class is working with.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
That's enough for us. Okay. Good. If everything is good, we can say bye bye. In the same room, Janela is also happening. So I'm sorry about this. Okay, all right then. Bye bye. Bye to Bolo.
Bye.
Like bye, 80 bye. Bye. Come on, amazing.
Bye.
80
bye.
Bye. Bye.
Finally, some bye to एकदम जोर से जोश में बोल दिया सब. Bye Swati.
Bye John. Bye.
Thank you.